here at the West Coast Swing. It is the first day of May.
Happy May!
A brand new month. And I'm Matt Stesner. We're here with Green Community Class Recap. So today we're talking all about shooting ducks. No, I'm not talking about outdoor hunting just because we're starting May, right? I'm not going to teach you how to shoot actual ducks. We're talking about West Coast Swing pattern. So, what it looks like? Last talking about slingshot, because it's very important to distinguish between the slingshot and the shooting duck variation, and they're common to slingshot and slingshot. So with the slingshot, I'm thinking about connecting linearly. Desmond's also thinking about connecting linearly. We're really emphasizing the straight line, even though we're slightly rotating from it. So remember this, just to go over the slingshot when you rotate, we talked about switching back and forth between your left foot and right foot, and going into compression, stretch, stretch when you're on the exit, you can settle a little bit more leaders into your hip. Followers, you can also do this if your leader's not moving you, leg to your leg. So settle, and then you can just do this in the right side pass, or you can add a double turn. So settle on your quad. So get into it, and you can do two turns. That's the same shot. Talked about further distinction between that and shooting ducks. For one thing, you're going to lift your hands and have this kind of different grip. This lets the follower know that something different is coming, and also gives more support for different angles of connection. From here, we're coming in, it starts similarly, but you're starting to rotate. Both triple as our base end, trip, step, trip, step, trip, step, trip, step. So, practice that a bunch. From there, we talked about some variations for the followers. Followers, you can start out just doing a simple ronde. Remember, I'm rotating with my body. I'm not thinking about rotating my foot. So I'm letting my body rotate, my foot follows. The body rotates, my foot follows. From there, you can also attach your foot kind of to your ankle, step. So rotate to my ankle, step. Or I can bring it up to my knee. If the song is a little bit happier, you can add kind of a little flick at the end, wherever you want to. It's important, followers, that when I'm sticking my foot to my leg, it's all the way stuck to my leg, right? It's not fire hydrant. I want to keep my leg attached to my standing leg. So we have followers trying out some of those variations while the players are still doing the triples. And from there, we let the leaders kind of relax and do their advanced footwork. So all they're doing is stepping on the even beats. So we're both stepping on two. And then we talked about different handholds you can do this pattern in. So you can do it from closed, right? Just regular arms position. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. The exit for both of these is when the follower is facing towards where you started. And they're on the left foot. You can add a little bit more prep and do inside turn. And then the last one we did, we start with left to left, over right to right, roll into your shoulder ice hold, two, three, and four, and then make sure your leader's hands are on the outside of the follower's hands so you can really steer this variation.
Followers, you want to mind your frame, so you're providing a little bit of compression into leader's hand, but not pushing out too much, and you're not getting smaller either. You have that buoyancy we talked about in the lab, where you're malleable without being too slow.
To get out of this one, all I'm going to do is release my left hand, take my right hand over for a single outside turn. That was your class. Thank you all for coming, and hope you enjoyed.